Tesla has submitted the final documents for production approval at the Gigafactory in Berlin, and several Model Y vehicles have been found in the company's factory. 2022 Tesla Model Y gets the official EPA range rating, but what does the entry-level RWD version do on the list? The crossover also received the highest score in the Insurance Institute for Highway Safety crash test and also received high ratings for headlights and collision prevention. The Tesla Giga Texas grand opening party is scheduled for early 2022. What better way to celebrate a good old-fashioned Texas barbecue party? The company has acquired graphite anode materials for battery production with a rare new offtake agreement. At the same time, Tesla's stock is now recovering with its valuation back to over $1 trillion amid a lot of talk about automaker and EV startup valuations. Finally, a dissatisfied Finnish Tesla owner detonated his electric car and the statue of Tesla founder Elon Musk to protest the cost of replacing the battery. Welcome to Technopool. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel, like this video and hit the notification bell icon to get updated with Tesla, Elon Musk and everything about the EV industry. Tesla and others have now submitted all the documents required for environmental approval, which will allow the Berlin Gigafactory to start production. Last year, Tesla encountered a lot of red tapes when trying to get approval to start production at the Berlin Gigafactory, a huge new factory in Brandenburg near Berlin. Recently, the Environmental Protection Organization managed to extend the public comment period for the project, thereby delaying the approval by 1 month. The new period ended last month, and Tesla is rumored to be approved soon, but it has not yet materialized. Earlier this week, we reported that the Ministry of Environment stated that Tesla and other entities have not yet delivered all required documents for approval. The government has now confirmed that all documents have been submitted. This is considered to be the last step to deliver the final approval. Tesla's goal is to start producing Model Y at this plant by the end of this year, but time is running out. The Chancellor of Brandenburg, Dietmar Woidt, recently stated that an approval decision may be made in early 2022. The start of production at the plant is critical for Tesla's expansion in Europe and its global operations, since Gigafactory Berlin production is going to free up production capacity at other factories to focus on local deliveries. But more important than starting production is the increase in mass production. While waiting to clean up the red tape, it was discovered that Tesla had already produced pre-production vehicles at the plant. The Tesla factory seems to be making progress. Several Model Y bodies and even entire vehicles were found on the recent drone flyover. We cannot confirm that these Model Y vehicles were produced at the Berlin Superfactory, but this is a possibility. The drone flyover also found some scrap from the factory, which may also indicate that some production work is in progress. The official EPA range and efficiency numbers for the 2022 Tesla Model Y are in. No surprise in terms of values, but the presence of the RWD version is. Tesla currently offers only two versions of the Model Y in the US, the Long Range AWD and the Performance. The Long Range is available with 19 and 20-inch wheels, while the Performance version comes only with 21-inch wheels. The Tesla Model Y RWD is not available at all, but it has its EPA rating as well. The entry-level 2022 Tesla Model Y RWD has an EPA range of 244 miles, 393 kilometers, which is the same as the 2021 model year version that was later retired. The same numbers suggest that it's not a new version with an LFP battery, but who knows, maybe such a new entry-level version will be introduced. The numbers would be then at least slightly different. As estimated by Tesla in November, the Model Y Long Range AWD has an EPA range of 330 miles, 531 kilometers. That's in the case of the 19-inch wheel version. The 20-inch wheel version has a range of 318 miles, 512 kilometers, according to Tesla. The difference is 12 miles, 19 kilometers, or 3.6%. An interesting thing is that the 2022 model year car has a higher range, despite the overall efficiency, including charging losses, being lower. Finally, the Tesla Model Y Performance with 21-inch wheels has an EPA range of 303 miles, 488 kilometers. 2021-22 Tesla Model Y won the Best Safety Choice Award from the Insurance Institute of Highway Safety. Only the most valuable vehicles can be labeled top safety pick. Model Y received the highest score in each of the 6 crash witness assessments of Insurance Institute of Highway Safety and thus obtained elusive labels, including small overlap front on the driver's side and small overlap on the passenger side. The agency said that the front overlap, moderate overlap front, original side, roof strength, and head restraint tests. The award only applies to Model Ys built after April 2021. Insurance Institute of Highway Safety spokesperson Joe Young told Teslarati that Model Y vehicles manufactured before May 2021 are not eligible for the highest safety choice award, but because the agency did not test the front collision prevention level of the vehicle, the reason is it cannot use vehicles manufactured before that date. In addition, Tesla has transitioned from a camera and radar-based system to a Tesla Vision system, a pure camera system that Tesla will use in its autonomous driving projects. The only Model Y vehicles permitted to have the rating were built after April 2021. Model Y received the highest score in each crash test, and the performance trim of the all-electric crossover also received a good rating for its headlights. The long-range variant's front beam has a slightly lower acceptable rating because it has some glare, which is a feature lacking in the performance variant, and therefore received a higher rating. Model Y has now joined the list of top safety options for its sibling Model 3. Tesla owns two of the several electric car positions that appear on the list. The other electric car selected was Volkswagen ID.4, which also received a good rating in each category, making it a place on the highly exclusive list, providing consumers with only the safest vehicles. In addition, Audi e-tron Sportback and ordinary four-door models also received the highest safety rating. It seems that Tesla Giga Texas production will begin early next year, which will make 2022 another exciting year for the company. Tesla CEO Elon Musk recently confirmed that a grand opening party for the Model Y and Cybertruck production facilities will be held early next year. As the construction of Giga Texas draws to a close, it is getting harder to see the interior of the huge Gigafactory and discover any interesting updates about the site. Elon Musk acknowledged this situation and announced that Tesla will hold a grand opening party for Giga Texas and visit the factory early next year. Tesla Gigafactory grand openings have always been fun events. Tesla has made it a point to celebrate every new factory. For Giga Shanghai, Elon Musk flew to China and gave people a sneak peek at his dance skills during the Giga Shanghai grand opening party, which also happened to include a marriage proposal. For Giga Berlin, the party didn't stop and neither did the dancing. Tesla planned a country fair party for the grand opening of the Berlin Gigafactory. During the Giga Fest, Elon Musk had another interesting surprise: Giga Beer. Tesla's grand opening party for Texas Gigafactory may be as fun as the Shanghai Gigafactory and Giga Berlin celebrations. In October, Elon Musk seemed to like the idea of hosting a Texas barbecue party for the Tesla Gigafactory in Austin. The Thrillist points out that the Central Texas-style barbecue has become the benchmark for evaluating the best slow-smoked meats. "When people say Texas-style, they mean Central Texas-style," it wrote. It would be interesting if Tesla held a BBQ party and provided all possible barbecue styles in Texas. In some respects, the grand opening of the Tesla Gigafactory has become a way for the company to get to know its neighbors. The celebration of the Tesla Gigafactory is a way for people in the local community to get acquainted with the electric car manufacturer and celebrate another milestone with them. A better way to celebrate with the local Austin community is to enjoy a delicious old-fashioned Texas BBQ. In a rare new offtake agreement with Sierra Resources Limited, Tesla obtained a new active anode material from graphite used in battery production. Australia's Sierra Resources Limited operates a graphite mine in Baroma, Mozambique. Sierra is currently expanding its facility to produce 10 kilotons of active anode material per year. Today, the company announced that Tesla has secured most of its production through a new offtake agreement. Tesla will offtake the majority of the proposed initial expansion of active anode material production capacity at Vidalia at a fixed price for an initial term of 4 years commencing from the achievement of a commercial production rate, subject to final qualification. Tesla also has an option to offtake additional volume from Vidalia subject to Sierra expanding its capacity beyond 10 kilotons per annum active anode material. Tesla rarely signs offtake agreements with junior mining companies, but in this case, the project seems to be quite advanced. As we previously reported, Tesla recently asked the US government to exempt China's graphite from tariffs, claiming that it cannot obtain minerals from other places. This request covers both artificial graphite and natural graphite. In addition, Tesla said it is working on a new chemical substance, which was obtained through an acquisition that uses new silicon in the anode to replace graphite. The automaker said that it plans to use this silicon in some versions of its 4680 battery cells that will be produced in-house. The company is currently ramping up production at its large-scale 10-gigawatt-hour pilot plant in Fremont and hopes to deploy 4680 battery cell production capacity in even larger volumes, 100-gigawatt-hour, at Gigafactory Berlin and Gigafactory Texas next year. But the automaker also stated that as the production of electric vehicles increases, it plans to use a variety of chemical substances and battery supplies to meet its rapidly growing demand for batteries. Tesla's stock price has soared by 7% today, and its market value has risen to more than $1 trillion. The reason behind the spike seems to be that Elon Musk said he had sold out the stock, but the CEO actually corrected his statement. Since Musk announced that he would sell his 10% stake in Tesla, the company's stock price has been falling. Earlier this week, it lost the incredible gains it made following the announcement that Hertz would be buying 100,000 Model 3 vehicles, which pushed Tesla's stock to over $1 trillion for the first time. However, yesterday and today have been reversed. Tesla's stock price has soared by 7%, which is crazy for a valuable company. The stock has now closed at more than $1,000 per share and has a market value of more than $1 trillion. Today's surge happened on a slow news day, and the main new information that contributed to the price increase appears to be Musk saying that he believes he sold enough shares to satisfy his statement that he would sell 10% of his Tesla stocks. As we reported before, based on the number of shares he announced in Tesla, he does not seem to have sold 10% of the shares. But Musk did sell more than 13 million Tesla shares last month. In addition to the bad signal of the CEO selling the stock, this puts direct pressure on the stock, even if it is mainly for taxes. In Tesla's last document, the company disclosed that as part of the plan formulated in September, Musk still has 2,637,455 stock options available for exercise. However, it sounds like Musk will not sell any additional stock except for part of his compensation plan. Tesla's stock is now recovering and its valuation has risen to more than $1 trillion due to a lot of discussion about the valuation of automakers and electric car startups. Rivian also went public recently, and its current valuation is $85 billion. Although only a few cars have been delivered, it has become one of the most valuable automakers in the world. Moving on to the last update, Tuomas Katainen used 66 pounds of explosives to blow up his 2013 Tesla Model S after a battery failure, and he faced a repair cost of £17,000, $22,000. The 26-year-old did not pay, but contacted the local YouTube user Pomaked T-Bomb Dudes. Tesla and Musk are facing a wave of complaints about the cost of replacing batteries, and third-party garages provide a quarter of the cost of replacing batteries. According to Electrek, another Tesla owner in the United States was told that it would cost him $22,500, £16,800 to replace the battery pack at the Tesla service center. Instead, he took it to a separate garage that provided a usable replacement battery for $5,000, $3,762 less than what Tesla originally offered. If the capacity is 150,000 miles or less than 70% within 8 years of purchase, Tesla's warranty covers battery replacement. However, owners of older models have to pay huge repair costs from Tesla because their battery is low and the car's mileage is shortened. Finnish YouTuber agreed to blow up Katainen's car and even put a dummy and billionaire Tesla co-founder Musk's face in the engine. The video showed that before Tuomas pressed the button and exploded the car to pieces, the video blogger strapped his engine with an explosive stick. The car was strapped with explosives on the rugged and snowy terrain of Tuomas's hometown of Finland. YouTubers trained high-definition cameras on the car to capture all the glory of the explosion from as many angles as possible. That's all for this video about Tesla, and thank you for watching. If you'd like to receive more updates, make sure you click the subscribe and bell icon and leave a comment, because it really matters.